gentlemen, 34 drivers will be at the starting line of the main World 600 here at Charlotte tomorrow. Those drivers who do not qualify today will go back home never having seen the green starter's flag. Those drivers bring their cars, their crews, and their hopes to Charlotte each year. Charlotte Speedway, nicknamed the granddaddy of NASCAR. Its spirit and its history is reflected in the kind of men who journey here. They take pride in coming, and Charlotte and NASCAR take pride in welcoming them. These men know the odds they face in this competition, and these sportsmen have learned through hard-won experience to accept the risk, live with disappointments in their constant quest for that often elusive victory. Tomorrow, when this great race begins, you will be witnessing the competitive best in the field of stock car auto racing. The finest mechanics, engineers, crew chiefs, without whose support no driver can exist. It is this combined effort that builds winning cars and winning teams. And speaking of winning teams, tomorrow, Richard Petty will receive the first leg trophy of this year's annual Wick Cup competition. Petty presently leads in the point stand and receives a check for $40,000. The Winston Cup competition has been yet another incentive for American stock car racing. And its list of winners reads like a who's who in the NASCAR Hall of Fame. On a personal note, Charlotte Motor Speedway has extended a special invitation to a man too long absent from the racing scene, Lee Petty, whose driving record was surpassed only by his sons, won his first NASCAR Grand National Competition here in Charlotte some years ago. We're hoping that Lee will join us today to watch his son attempt to win this famed classic, and by so doing, be the first driver in NASCAR history to win every major speedway competition. Gentlemen, start your engines!
Yeah, I know. Not for 6 years. Why?
Don't matter why. I just don't.
Well, I had never won in Charlotte.
Well, it's all right, son. Nobody wins them all.
Well, I'd be the first.
Well, if you want it, then you go on out and take it.
Yeah, if you come, I might can win.
I told you I don't race and I don't watch racing. How many times I tell you that? I don't race and I don't watch races.
Well, if you come, I might can win.
I don't race. I don't watch races. I don't race. I don't watch races.
Richard Petty in car 43 and teammate Pete Hamilton have dominated this race here at Darlington today. Petty is presently running in first position and Hamilton is moving in fifth position. Hamilton is driving car 42, a number that has carried several drivers these past few years since Lee Petty retired from racing. Petty lost control of his car. The electronic flag is out. You people on the road, stand clear for the emergency vehicle. Stand clear, please.
Julie, you'll stay as a kid.
Petty's unconscious.
Yeah, you go and pound.
Infield clear. Clear the infield, please. The fire crew is moving out onto the track as the caution flag slows down the field. Everybody, please remain calm. They're pulling Petty from the totally demolished vehicle now.
You two, stay here.
Still on it. There's nothing you can do. I'll speak about it. Okay? You better get out there. We got a petty car in the race. We still need a big crew boy. I'll be here. the pack, you got to push hard in the rough spots. I said you got to push hard in the rough spots. George Fellows, automotive trend, a little magazine we put up in Greensboro.
That's my bad side.
I said my name was Fellows.
Yeah.
I'm a writer.
I know, I heard you.
I'm curious. Next driver like you, 3 times Grand National Champion. You figure this will dull your boys' taste for driving like it did yours when you took one through the fence?
Now, if I understand that question correctly, you better ask that of Richie.
But after you went through the wall of Daytona, you walked away from racing. Why?
It's my choice.
Thing is, though, you haven't been to a race since.
I don't race, and I don't watch races.
Not even your sons?
This conversation has ended.
Racing's been good to the Petties. Very good. Your news. I think you owe me some answers.
Now, what we got here is a matter of a possible concussion. Now, Richard may snap out of it and just shuffle out of here. On the other hand, he may not. Until I know which way it's going, I don't owe you nothing. Well, that's the end of this conversation. What I am and where I'm from is my concern and my concern only.
Sounds like you did a little sweetening on that engine.
Yeah, sure, a little bit here and there.
First car I ever bought, I rebuilt. Yeah, watch the upholstery there, Richie. Don't mess it up. Yeah, it was a 28 Ford. I tore it down from firewall to radiator. Got about another 10 to 15 miles an hour out of it, too.
Get out.
What?
I said get out. Hey,
my bad side.
What?
My bad ear.
Thank you. North Carolina?
Curtis Cross.
You from
Quebec?
Montreal, Baton Rouge.
I move around a lot.
Yeah, I can tell.
You think you feel like going in and warming up some of that cornbread?
Lee and Richard have been kidnapped by some wild fool in a hopped-up car. We have driven this truck across a quarter of the state and ourselves half out of our minds looking for them, and you want me to heat up cornbread?
Well, you know you're the only one who can make that old gas stove work. Oh, Elizabeth, now don't worry. Lee and Richard, they're bound to come home sooner or later.
Maybe in a pine box.
Hey, you ran out of my wagon.
Oh, by golly, I did, didn't I?
Julie, what are you going to do about it?
Well, I'm going to have to buy him a new one, I expect.
I ain't talking about the darn wagon.
I'll tell you what I'm going to do about it. I'm going in the house and warm up that cornbread my own self.
Hey, Ma, you think digging at your desk.
Well, you do have a way of putting things, Maurice. Come on.
model beefed up 60 horsepower. I tell you, we left them revenueers like they were standing still.
Isaac,
where you been?
Run out of gas. Why, they nobody would have caught it. That Curtis, he drives like there's no tomorrow.
Curtis?
Curtis Cross, the former owner of this lovely little piece of machinery.
Are you going to tell me where you've been, Lee? What, former owner? What did you say that former owner for, Lee?
Because it's the truth.
Well, I know you don't lie.
Well?
Well?
Did you see us take off?
Like a rooster after a June bug.
Yeah.
Where you been, Lee?
In jail.
Oh.
Yeah, he was carrying 60 gallons of white lightning in the back of this thing here. Isn't she beautiful? Look at that space in there, huh? Yeah, and it took us all the better part of 2 hours for Curtis and me to convince the law that
Richard and I was just along for the ride. And
Curtis?
Curtis Cross, former owner.
Former owner?
Former owner.
Well, the poor fella, he had to have a lawyer, you know. So I just got one heck of a good deal.
You bought this thing?
Is it really yours?
Well, yeah, you like it?
Does a cat have a tail?
How much you pay for it, Lee?
Looky here, 180 horsepower.
How much did you pay for it, Lee?
It's got special carbs on it, look at that, and a special ground valve.
What did you pay for it, Lee?
$300.
$300? What are you going to do with this car?
Did I show you the suspension? No. Look, see? Right underneath there, they got those tie bars in there. Keep from heeling down on the curves, you know?
Lee, what are you going to do with this car?
What are you going to do with it, Lee?
We're going racing!
Oh, no!
That's what I figured.
Lee, the house is on fire. Lee, the house is on fire.
What'd you say, honey?
Hey, Lee, the house is on fire.
Well, the house is on fire. Why didn't you say something?
Oh.
I told you, you should have heated the cornbread.
Well, I guess we'll go and move in with my mom.
Well, there is a bright side.
Yeah, well, I'd like to see it.
Well,
I mean, now I gotta go racing.
No.
We gotta get ourselves a new house, clothes.
We own a truck, remember?
That's faster.
Yeah.
Well, what do you think?
Well, what do you think, I think?
Well, if I knew, I wouldn't ask.
75, 85, 95, 110, and 20% for the house.
20? Oh, my. Well, there you go. There's half for Mama, put in the bank, and half for Baby.
Hey, do you know something I don't know?
Yeah, I know the Baby needs new tires.
Now, how does it feel winning our first race?
Well, the car costs $300. The house is worth about $12. His lost wages are about $6. I figure this win has cost us about $2,000.
Well, man has got to do what he's got to do.
I know I can always depend on you. Loyal, faithful, trusting and such. They're at my side when I'm in a clutch. Friend, friend, you and I, we'll never hunger for humble pie. Clap out and running high, we're gonna kiss tomorrow goodbye. Friend, friend, sure as you're born, things will look better tomorrow morning. 6 ways to breakfast and back again. You'll always be my bosom friend.
us. You fool me.
I'd rather foul you than follow you. Well, let's see now. That's $250. That's $250 for you and $300 for me.
What are you talking about? I was going to take first place.
Back there. As far as I'm concerned, this is a race that was run for the money.
Why, you... Ah.
There you go, boy.
How is he? He's not yours to worry about, Coley. And in case you hadn't noticed, I blew an engine. I was out of it 20 laps before you hit that wall. You were out of it years ago, Coley.
Lee?
No, he's still unconscious.
What, can I see him?
We wait. We wait.
I never will get used to the way you two handle things like this.
Well, a lot of words out here ain't going to help him in there.
Everything is going to be all right.
Scratch two petty cars.
How bad?
The car's totaled.
He's okay.
If I wrapped up, Dale, call it a day.
Anything?
Nope. I'll let you know.
You gonna be okay?
We'll be here.
Everything's gonna be just fine. Except I'm going out of my head. Sanity total. Well, what could I expect? It had to happen this way. Bound to hang myself with my mouth sooner or later.
Good idea to get you on the yearbook staff so you could break in and meet the kids since you're new here. I didn't think they'd work you to death after school, you know? You know?
What?
Why I got you on the yearbook staff?
No.
I just told you.
What?
Why I got you on the yearbook staff. To meet the kids because you're new here.
Yes, I am.
Yes, you am what?
What?
Okay, which one is it? You like them tall or short?
The tall one on the right.
Petty.
Who?
Richard Petty. Lee Petty is his father.
Oh.
Lee Petty, the race car driver.
Oh.
You want some advice?
Okay.
Forget it.
Why?
Because you ain't got the right equipment. I mean, you got nice lines, kid, but you ain't got a carburetor or a transmission or whatever.
What?
All Richard Petty ever talks about is race cars, he and Bobby.
Nothing else?
If Richard doesn't talk about cars, he just doesn't talk. Believe me, we've all tried.
Oh, I don't know nothing about race cars. If my daddy drives over 50, I get sick.
Like I said, forget it. You want a Coke? There's a yellow thing with black spots on your neck. Maybe you'd rather eat that.
Maybe tomorrow. Hi. How's your plug? Your spark plugs, I mean. What are your favorite brands? Brands. It is your favorite brand. A plug, that is. Well, I guess you don't have a favorite. Well, like I say, you've seen one, you've seen them all. Say, listen, would you like to drive me home? I mean, I really would like it if you'd drive me home.
Okay.
Do you drive?
Huh?
I mean, like your father.
No, he's faster.
Faster?
I pity him.
Well, I do too.
You do too what?
Pity him.
No, pity. Me and Morris pity him.
Oh.
We always have.
Oh. Do you enjoy pitting him?
Sure. When we first started, he couldn't afford a cruise, so we filled in. Uncle Julie helped us in.
Matter of fact, he couldn't even afford the car. Sort of borrowed one.
A couple of NASCAR fishers better get those baby faces out of sight. You too.
Do I look like a kid?
Have all your life.
I'm not a rich man. This is the only car I own. I'm beginning to have some doubts.
Well, I can understand that. Mr. Phillips, I really can understand it. But don't you see that with your half of the big prize money that I'm going to win here today, why, you can buy 10 or 10, 20 of these
cars. I don't know nothing about auto racing, Mr. Petty, but I do know there's a certain risk.
Risk? Well, now, don't you worry none about that, Mr. Phillips. If I were you, don't you worry your head none about it. I'm going to take all the risk.
But what if you wreck or something?
Wreck?
Mr.
Phillips, that's not a nice thing to say. I mean, that's no way to talk to a man. I mean, you can undermine a man's confidence with a talk like that.
I didn't mean to hurt his feelings.
I think you hit him right where he lives.
I've heard he's really very good.
Oh, well, tell him.
Tell him what?
Well, tell him what you just said. Tell him you heard he's very good.
Listen, Mr. Petty, I know your reputation as a race driver is just real good.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I don't think I got nothing to worry about.
Yeah, well, I appreciate your concern, Mr. Phillips. But you understand, of course, that I never think about or worry about my own driving.
Well, then, I want you to drive it. I want you to drive my car in this race right here today, now.
Man, I don't know.
No, I want you to drive it. I got every confidence, Mr. Petty, that me and you are going to make a lot of money.
Well, no, not if you're scared, no.
But I ain't scared, Mr. Petty. I ain't scared a bit. I want you to drive my car.
Well, really? I mean, you're sure?
I'd be proud if you drove my car.
Are you sure now?
I'm sure, Mr. Petty. I'm sure. I'm sure you're going to drive my car just fine.
You know what I learned? Well, I'm going to tell you what I learned. I learned that your car ain't fit for racing. It's too heavy.
The suspension is like a baby buggy. It sucks oil like a hog, and it drinks gas like a drunken sailor. It drifts in the corners like a rowboat, and it steers like a pregnant truck. Imagine you get killed in that thing. In short, it ain't worth the powder to blow it to hell. Congratulations!
I'm sorry. I'm really sorry.
Holly, why are we living like this?
Well, a man's got to do what he's got to do.
Driver's meeting. Whatever it is, says it's okay with me.
My God, he still calls his old man Daddy.
Do I know you?
Oh, Richard. Meet Ed Kohler.
He's been driving Norton tracks mostly.
Your Daddy took a first away from me at Irish Hills last week. I thought I'd come down here and just take it back.
You're welcome to try, if you stick by the rules.
I drive by only one rule. Do whatever you have to win. Everything else just words.
Now listen to me, Kohler. I've called these meetings so us drivers can get together, so we can get a voice with NASCAR. Now they're nice people, and we're all growing. And there's a lot of money in it, especially now with factory sponsorship and all. Now if we don't kill ourselves with crazy driving, we might all share in it.
I heard that in there.
Apparently you aren't listening.
I heard it. I just think it's stupid. I'm on the track. I don't intend to worry about any union brother in the car behind me.
Or in front of you?
Anywhere. Racing's not a team sport, Petty. It was never meant to be. The track's one of the few places left in this world where the man with the guts for it can take it all. Don't you ever forget that when you race against me. Ever.
He makes me so mad I could just spit.
Good luck tomorrow,
Richard.
Oh, by the way, I've wished your father the same.
Sounds fair enough.
Good.
Let's go.
Wait a minute.
What?
Do you have to race against your daddy tomorrow?
Well, tomorrow's just the first time that we've had two cars in the same race.
Well, you could hire another driver to take your place.
We're a family. We're a team.
So you should respect each other.
We do respect each other. But what's that got to do with the race tomorrow?
Richie, come here.
Well, did you do any good?
Nope.
Women is having a tizzy.
Well, I don't see why they should. Now, you go on and order them out for them. I'm here a few days, aren't you?
I'm going home.
I'll drive you.
I'll drive myself.
It's snowing on her.
Same thing that's snowing on me.
Now, you just hush up. Just hush up. Now, it has been discussed. It is all settled.
No, it is not settled, and it is not. And will you quit turning your bad ear to me? Every time we argue, he turns his bad ear. I first started noticing it about 5 years ago.
What's that?
I said he was... Oh, yes, smart aleck kid.
It's simply a matter of good business, that's all, isn't it? I mean, the first two cars that come in, they're sharing the prize money. We're that much closer to attracting the sponsor. It don't matter which of us comes in first in which car.
Now, I know you two better than anybody else in the whole world. And I know it is not going to be that simple. Now, you won too many times to ever want to settle for second. And you are too anxious for your first win ever to hold back. Now, when you two go out there to that track tomorrow, I just want you to remember that I said it first.
Well, she's right about one thing. Yeah,
I only drive one way.
To win.
It's always been that way with me.
Yeah, always will be. For both of us.
He's going to say that once too often.
One question.
Yeah?
How?
How what?
How could you do that?
Do what?
Hi, honey.
You're grinning.
Yeah.
You're still grinning.
So?
How can you after what he just done to you?
All he done was win the race.
Yeah.
It could have been the other way around.
Yeah, but it wasn't.
It wasn't.
You made him look foolish in front of thousands of people.
You feel foolish?
I don't feel foolish. You feel foolish?
Yeah, I don't feel foolish. You don't look foolish.
Why did you have to protest? I mean, who would have known the difference? Nobody would have known.
We'd have known.
We'd have known.
Yeah.
You really don't care. You really don't care.
Sure, I care I didn't win the race. I'm going to get him next time.
Yeah, you want to bet there, boy.
You're crazy. You're both crazy. The whole lot is crazy.
You know, I think you better marry that girl. You.
you yelling about?
You know what day it is.
Tuesday the 21st.
Our wedding day.
I know that, honey.
Then what are you doing out here?
This thing's supposed to turn 5,000 RPMs, and I can't get it up about 4,500. I'm trying to make adjustments on the carburetor.
Richard, our guests are here.
Honey, I know that, but if I don't get this thing running, we'll come back empty.
I don't know about your RPM or your carburetor. I just want you to get in the house and marry me.
Honey, I got every intention of it.
I know they just named you Rookie of the Year. I know you just won $8,000. I know without the money we couldn't afford to get married, but I am not going to share you with a race car on my wedding day.
It'll only take a couple of minutes.
Richard, get in the house and get dressed.
Uncle Bert Strutter.
Long day.
Everybody had a good time.
There's some punch left downstairs.
Was the carburetor. I got the RPMs up now. It's turning 5,000 now.
In years to come, someone will ask, someone always does, about my wedding night. Well, I'm thankful I'll be able to look them straight in the eye and tell them that on my wedding night, the most important night of my life, Richard did finally get his RPM up.
Petty and son Richard again battle each other on the track. Richard's young son Kyle will be watching his father and grandfather from the stands. It's Kyle's first look at American stock car auto racing, but judging from the Petty family's past performance, we kind of feel it won't be his last. Who knows? Things keep up. Before long, we're liable to see three generations of Petties right out there on the track. Meanwhile, young Kyle is going to be witnessing a battle of giants here today. After only 36 laps, 10 cars are already out of the competition because of mechanical failure. Lee Petty and Ed Kohler are fighting it out from third position behind Firehall Roberts and Marvin Chan. Chris Cross forced to pit a few moments ago with some problem, which apparently has put him out of the race. Car 84 is under control. Car number 46. Petty is out of control. He's upside down. inferno! Those of you on the infield, you spectators on the infield, clear for the emergency vehicles. Clear for the emergency vehicles, please. Petty's all right. He's all right. He's running from the car. Petty's apparently uninjured.
Did he crash?
Yes, honey. You could say that.
Lap of this race, Fireball Roberts and Marvin Panch have been trading the lead with Junior Johnson and Lee Petty as the blistering pace continues here at Daytona International Speedway. Ed Kohler of Irish Hills continues to challenge the leader, but his car, number 73, can't quite pull to the front of the pack. He's uninjured, and somebody is watching over these drivers here today. And now Lee Petty makes his move, challenging the leaders. And now Ed Kohler tries to draft on him. Oh, he's trying to get under him. And Ed Kohler has hurtled through the fence in turn four. Again, the yellow caution is out. And this race turns into a driver's nightmare. The caution is out, but most of the drivers haven't seen it yet. Petty and Kohler literally left the track in a split second. Again, the emergency vehicles are being dispatched, trying to get across the track. And the cars finally respond to the caution flag. There's heavy smoke visible over the fence. One of the drivers seems to have run free of the wreckage of car number 73. That would be Ed Kohler. Kohler is all right, but Petty's car is totally demolished and in flames. They're trying to pull him free of the wreckage now, but the car is totally demolished. We have no report on Petty's condition. You people on the infield, please clear for the ambulance. Please clear. Please clear from the ambulance.
Richard and Maurice come back yet?
Curtis called. I think they all went out looking for Kohler. I can't say I tried or wanted to stop them.
Well, you should have. Kohler didn't have anything to do with what happened today.
He hurt Lee.
Lee hurt himself. Now, if the track felt that Kohler had fouled him, they would have lodged a complaint.
Maybe it wasn't obvious to them, but it was, it is to us.
Linda, Lee has been racing all his life. And he knows the risks. He wants it. It's what keeps him alive. And Richard is cut out of the same cloth.
I can't accept that.
Oh, well, you'd better. After today, we are in for some tough times. We're nearly broke. So, you had better get on Richard's team, or you're going to have some lonely days ahead.
This isn't exactly the best time to announce it. I'm going to have a baby.
Well, I am glad to know that you and Richard have been working at something together.
Why don't you spool down that Winnie of yours?
My, ain't he a chuckle and a half tonight? Old Ledford here getting a little edgy. Put a man through the fence today. Little pause for thought there.
Petty put himself through that fence.
Curious to me. Too much time following you around could get to be fearful.
That occurs to me. Also, Rand usually is a shaky place to live.
He should know. He's been there a lot more times than Petty.
Only to visit, sweet lips. Only to...
I just got a call from NASCAR this afternoon after the race.
They drove me off the circuit.
Drove it off? Why?
Trying to organize the drivers.
We've all been trying to organize.
Yeah, but he's the one who told them I started it.
They can't do that to you, Curtis.
Well, they've done it. One tired, faded, also ran. That of a cheap way to make an example, isn't it? So you see, he's mine too.
Well, I told you how it was with me.
Yeah, whatever you can get by with you.
It was an accident. That's what they'll call it.
That's what they'll call it.
Look, I'm sorry he's hurt, but it's got nothing to do with me.
Hey, Kohler, did you know that old Curtis got thrown off the circuit today?
I heard.
Before anybody else out there.
Told you I was against you.
Yeah, that's right, you did. But let me tell you something real special. Lee Petty raised his son with real manners, sense of fair play, and always told him to act like gentlemen.
Good for them.
And they don't drink. Did you know they don't drink?
Good for them. Look, if you compete, you get hurt. We all know that. Betty competed and got hurt.
Happened to any of us.
You're right, Kohler. It can happen to any of us. Sure glad when you come here and start no fight.
Well, he could have had accidents, you know?
Yeah.
I'm glad he did because he finally thought you better know.
Yeah,
he tried to teach us pretty good manners most of the time.
I've got to get my wheels free.
Curtis. Richard?
Well, I'll be, how are you?
Okay. How you been doing?
Oh, fine. I had it going pretty good, you know. But I blew a hose 2 laps short of the first money.
Such a was.
It's good to see you, Curtis.
Hey, how are you doing pretty good for yourself?
Yeah, things is looking up. Yeah, well, I come down here just for kicks, you know. These outlaw tracks are a hell of a lot of fun. Just to keep my hands in it, you know. I got a lot of good things going for myself. Real good things. Listen to me trying to bully you. Why do you have to find me in a place like this?
Curtis, I need you here. It's been about a year and a half since Daddy had his wreck, and he's talking about driving again.
What I hear, he can't handle it.
You're right. But I don't want to be the one that has to tell him, but I think you can.
Mm-mm. Listen. I have driven, and I've seen many more times this tailpipe than he's seen of mine. I'm not going to talk to him.
You can do it, Curtis. You're the only one that can. Just be gentle.
Gentle with your boy?
Yeah, you just kind of drop around for breakfast in the morning and take him outside and just, you know, talk old times.
You really believe he'll be happy to see me?
Heck yeah, the whole crowd would be glad to see you. Just change your shirt.
Gone 2 hours. Some conversation they're having.
Let's go find
Curtis, he was driving a
yellow modified. I don't know who's in that silver.
But you do have the distinct impression that your father is in it.
Yeah, it does kind of look that way, doesn't it?
Well, would you care to go out there and flag him in before he wrecks what good bones he ain't already broken?
Would you?
Well, are you just going to stand there?
No, I think I'm going to sort of yell for him.
Oh.
Yeah.
Are you two having fun?
Well, you beat me by 10 feet.
The truth is, I should have beat you but 10 laps. No, the real truth is that neither of us are what we once were. So that's it. That's all. That's the end of it.
Mr. Petty? Guess he just wanted to take a little nap.
Never could wake him up. Come on, let's go home.
Pretty good, huh?
Yes, sir.
Right,
new car this year. Again. Remember the first day we met and you gave me a ride home?
Yeah.
Did you know I was scared stiff?
Why you bring that up now?
No reason. Except your driving scares the daylights out of me sometimes.
Me too. Sometimes.
Well, man's got to do what a man's got to do.
You know, you ought to marry that girl.
I did.
Oh, that's right, you did, didn't you? Yeah, you did it all. All of it's been done.
Well, not quite.
Not quite? Well, you got trucks over there to pull trailers to haul cars in. You got buildings that go from here to Never Never Land. You're building 14 race cars. You build on any more, you're going to end up in the road.
That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about Charlotte.
What about Charlotte?
Well, we're running out of this coming week.
Yeah, I know. I read the paper.
I'd like for you to come.
I don't race, and I don't watch races.
For 6 years, you hadn't been. Why?
Don't matter why, I just don't.
Well, I hadn't ever won it, Charlotte.
It's all right, son. Nobody wins them all.
Well, I can be the first.
Well, if you want it, you go on out and get it.
You come, and maybe I will.
I told you, I don't race, and I don't watch races. Now, how many times do I have to tell you that? Better. I gave him, he got more of for himself. I mean, he don't need me and Charlotte.
You needed him. Him and Maurice. Charlotte in 1948. Barred Buick and two scared kids. Now you needed them, and they was there. Now you owe him, Lee.
Owe him? Owe him? I gave him everything I had. I raised him good. I raced him and I beat him. And I taught him how to race others and beat them. Owe him. No, woman, that debt has been paid.
Lee, we're not talking about debts. Deep down inside you, you ain't quit. Oh, you think you have. But let you have it. You still want to be first. Well, you are the best man I ever knew. But you can't be first no more. And you can't quit. So you're just hanging somewhere in there in the middle. And that's a mighty poor place for a man to live. If you ever want to have peace of mind, you are going to have to go to Charlotte with Richard.
I'd like for you to come.
I don't race. I don't watch races.
But why?